But they don't like the fact that we investigate the Fourth Estate. They don't think that that's ethical. They say, how dare you aim your cameras against news people? You know, democracy dies in darkness, so forth and so on. And I say, I think it's probably the most important thing to investigate the press. Because we believe our premise is, and this is a Solzhenitsyn line I've shared with you, that the Fourth Estate has more power than all three branches of government. The ABC News has more power than Congress. Politics is downstream from culture, and culture is downstream from data. So, and data is downstream from the press.
James O'Keefe, so great to have you back on American Thought Leaders.
Good to see you.
We're fist pumping, not because I'm trying to be cool, but because we know there's coronavirus already in the U.S. and better be safe than sorry.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, indeed.
So, James, you know, I saw your tweet a couple of days ago now about the ABC senior reporter, senior correspondent. I saw the video. What was fascinating to me about the video, and I think I tweeted about this actually, was that while there was clear bias that was exhibited in this, there was actually a lot of very honest discourse and things, you know, that people should probably know in that video as well.
Very honest video, very profound statements that most journalists frankly agree with what he said. I mean, he's talking about how his bosses are not connected with voters, they don't let him report the news. He talked about Disney, ABC is owned by Disney, is selling products for Marvel's, you know, comic book characters. They care more about that than they do about the news. He says the commercial imperative is incompatible with news, the news business. He says all these, and he also says he's a socialist, but then he says we don't give Trump enough credit. So the media, he's been suspended. The media is not talking about all of those other profound things that he has said. They're just attacking ABC for suspending a guy for being a socialist. I'm not sure it's that simple, Jan.
Well, no, and I thought, I mean, all these things that you just mentioned, I mean, it's super interesting. Just basically, I think what he was saying was, we're not really doing news as
yes.
news should be done.
Yes.
Right?
Like, that's what he's
that
saying.
That was what I got.
And yeah. None of these journalists in the Fourth Estate seem to want to practice introspection. They're not willing to actually self-examine and challenge how they do business. And this guy, this is like a shot across the bow. Not only does he say the things, ABC suspends him. Everyone's talking about it. I mean, like USA Today, Associated Press, Washington Post. But none of them are willing to acknowledge the fundamental core issues he addressed. They're just attacking the surface. Oh, he's a socialist. Because that's the soup they swim in. They're all political, Jan. They all look at it through the lens of ideology. And that's not what he was talking about. He was talking about the news business from a man who's been doing this for decades. He's an Oxford-educated man. And they're not willing to address these things. And I'm willing to address these things. This is why Project Veritas exists. This is what we've been talking about for years. The Pravda, the problems in our media and how it works. So, unfortunately, we're just going to have to keep doing more of these things, Jan.
So I'm guessing that you have a few more up your sleeve.
What's remarkable about the ABC story is that after we broke it in November with the Amy Robach Epstein cover-up story that we did, more than one insider came to us with an ABC News. Now there's multiple people working for the company. So it's kind of this whipsaw effect where an insider comes forward, we protect that person's identity, and then other insiders trust us. And I've said this to you before, the thing that's remarkable about these insiders is they say, we can't trust the Washington Post, we can't trust the New York Times. We won't go to them with this information because they don't care about what we have to say and what we're seeing. There's only one organization that we can go to, and that's Project Veritas. And maybe the Epic Times as well.
Well, you know, and you have this very, you know, interesting rule, which I am aware of, that anything you're going to put out, it has to be on video. So you have the evidence that
yeah,
that's,
I mean,
pretty much,
in this case, the rule is we don't report anything unless you can see the people's lips moving. Now, in this case, you couldn't actually see the guy's lips because the camera was shot at his waist and his shoulders. But the bottom line is we don't report anything unless you can hear it, unless you can verify it with the firsthand information. You know, in journalism, we get attacked for that, you know, that shaky hidden camera gotcha thing. Someone actually said that, and I said, would you prefer that I anonymously quoted him? Is that what you'd prefer? It's a less transparent form of reporting. when you can't actually see and hear the footage. So, and then they say, well, you film this guy in a bar and he's amongst his colleagues. Well, that's what reporters do. They report things from meetings, you know, through hearsay quotes. We actually show the actual firsthand information. We think that's a more transparent form of reporting. And I hope that people in journalism have the moral courage to go on the record and actually say the things publicly that they're willing to say privately. People say, well, these people are collateral damage. You're putting people on blast. First of all, this guy was in New Hampshire. David Wright was working on the primary. He was in a bar. He should know better. He was talking to his colleagues. This is the world we live in, and we think the public have a right to know what these news correspondents actually believe when they broadcast this stuff to 8 million people and they say that we're manufacturing consent.
You know, it's interesting. How much of a positive impact do you think your reporting will have on actually reforming the news industry?
I believe, I mean, I'm biased in favor of our mission, obviously, but I believe that this is the purest form of reporting. And people, it really comes down to a situation ethics. Because they would never attack me if I was investigating, you know, a MAGA person saying he was part of the Klan. They'd probably win a Nobel Peace Prize for exposing that sort of thing with hidden cameras. But they don't like the fact that we investigate the Fourth Estate. They don't think that that's ethical. They say, how dare you aim your cameras against news people? You know, democracy dies in darkness, so forth and so on. And I say, I think it's probably the most important thing to investigate the press. Because we believe our premise is, and this is a Solzhenitsyn line I've shared with you, that the Fourth Estate has more power than all three branches of government. The ABC News has more power than Congress. Politics is downstream from culture, and culture is downstream from data. So, and data is downstream from the press. And ABC News and Twitter work hand in hand. In fact, stories don't trend unless blue check mark credentialed verified reporters, of which they would consider Epoch Times not one, unless those people tweet about it, it's not going to trend on Google and Twitter. Therefore, we have to hold the press to account. And that's what this is. It's a shot across the bow. I think there's a reckoning happening here. And that's why you're seeing the tonality of these pieces a little more fair to us than you otherwise have seen.
I can see you're channeling your mentor here.
Andrew Breitbart?
Yes.
No one was like Andrew Breitbart. Him and I were very different people in many respects. We both firmly believed in the power of the press, and it's kind of a dichotomy, because on one hand we have to hold them to account, and on the other hand we acknowledge their power and know that unless they cover our stories, people aren't going to know about them. So we have to do both things simultaneously, which is a very weird, surreal circumstance. I'm simultaneously investigating the press while also acknowledging their power.
James O'Keefe, such a pleasure to have you.
Good to see you.